TMNT time! Hello, welcome to another figure view. Today we're gonna have a look at the NECA Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, The Secret of the Ooze, Toka and Raza 2-pack. Oh my god, I've watched TMNT 2 a billion times as a kid and half a billion times as an adult. These figures, these characters are very near and dear to me. And I like, the story behind it is basically, the TMNT movies had the license to the TMNT, but not the cartoon show, so they couldn't have Bebop and Rocksteady. Instead, they created their own mutant monsters, and what we got is Toka and Raza. So, without further ado, let's have a look at the figures. Or according to other sources, Eastman and Laird didn't want to have Bebop and Rocksteady in the movie because it wasn't a cartoon creation, a comic book creation, that is. Whatever the reason behind them was, they're still amazing. Let's have a look at the size. Raza stands at about 18.5 centimeters to the top of his hairy head, which means we're going up to 7.45 inches tall. For Toka, 17.5 centimeters, which means we're going up to a little shy of 7 inches, well, almost up there with that. For your size comparisons, I have Jalter, here are the original Playmates toys, Super 7 Leonardo, Super 7 Shredder, Super 7 Bebop, NECA Movie Mikey, NECA Movie Shredder, and Darkseid. Now I want to have a look at them one by one, starting off with Raza and all the furry goodness and these crazy eyes. Man, the head sculpt is straight up scary, something out of a horror movie. You got the blue eyes, which really stare you down, very accurate to the movie. And the fur, the textured fur throughout all of the body, not just the head, is quite frankly just amazing looking. Have all this texture which is brought to life even more with the paint job. Got some brighter spots and a couple of layers on there. Then you got the inside of the mouth. Yes, you can open the mouth. On mine it is fairly loose, but it does stay in place, so it's okay. The teeth look rotten and dirty, with a nice kind of shiny paint job in the middle of it, especially for the tongue. It has like a black tongue. Jesus. In the back, you got some real chain and some metal plates on both sides with the shoulder pads connected. Really, the fur pops even more here as you have like a darker line that goes through in the middle. And all of the metal has really like this rusty, worn, ugly look. The paint job on it, it's quite phenomenal. It looks pretty darn realistic on all of these parts. As you move down to the arms, you got like the fingernails, which are painted nice and ugly with some more dirt on there, and the bandages, and all these like forearm decorations, which it looks like it's a tire with some nails in it. The nails are completely floppy, so we will not cut yourself on it. It is also kind of rounded, so just be aware of that. This is not really connected, just like via the chain which goes around, which still has a pretty tight lock on it, so it doesn't really flop around that much, but you have some wiggle motion on it. For the shoulder pads, they are connected to the torso, so you can lift that up also. It doesn't have a ball hinge or whatever, it's just like a soft-ish connection with like rubbery plastic in there. Loincloth down there, dude, again with the paint job, it looks brighter in some parts, it looks dirty, it looks rugged. And then the other one down there, and it's... Well, do I give this? No, I don't give this sponsor time, that's just weird. Whatever. Got some more tires, cut up tires on his thighs and the knee pads with some more tiny, tiny hubcaps. Well, it looks like hubcaps over here. What even is that? Is that like hubcap from like a mini? Knee pads with some more bandages under there and the big, big dirty toenails with even some detail under there and some peg holes if you want to put them on the base. Toka also is no slouch whatsoever. You got the big red eyes and a little bit more of a goofy face, but that's even made more goofy with this eyebrows, which you can rotate. Well, they just kind of are connected back here, so you can bring that up and down to really bring those expressions from the movie to life, which I very much appreciate. The beak is just connected softly, so you can lift it up a little bit. Cannot really rotate it, but that's really just, I guess, to get in with the mouth, so you can open the mouth. Same as with Raza. It's really like the range of it looks really weird, but you don't have to do it all the way if you don't want to. But I think like there was the scene where Raza ate the donuts and Toka wanted some as well, which one like, no, 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 which was kind of like that. And I think it actually opened pretty widely. So anyway, the detail in there obviously is stunning. Little teeth, again, shiny inside of it. And also like kind of dirty on the beak, there's tons of shading on it. And it gets brighter on the lower part on the neck, have some dots as well with the big, big spiky shell in the back. Unfortunately, it has some paint issues. Well, you could say it's dirt effect, but I think there's just paint missing on some of the spikes. I mean, there's a lot of it going into, and the shell itself looks absolutely fantastic, the mold and the paint on it. Really, again, realistic, brings it to life, and that's really what they've been excelling at just creating something that's so close to the movie, it's scary. We got some more spikes on side, and some darker and some brighter shading where the muscle work really shines, really brings it out very nicely, you know, where the muscle pops really, it gets brighter, and like in the nooks over here, it gets darker. Then you got the elbow pads with some white bandages around it, all painted in like a little bit of a dark black wash, whatever, to make it look dirty. For your claws, got some more painted ugly fingernails on this side as well. And the shell itself in the front also has like a very nice look with the darker and a little brighter orange in it. Has a couple of layers on there, really from the dark to like a brownish and obviously the orange. And for the big, big calves, holy crap, really muscly looking, and the knee pads and the big sculpted giant feet with more claws on it, and the peg holes are really connected in a weird position over there, but yeah, don't care about that. For your articulation, you know the drill, it's neck articulation, so absolutely heat it up before you move it around. I actually spent like a session where I just spent like 5 minutes just pointing the hairdryer at these guys just to loosen everything up. Let's hope nothing breaks off. Head moves forward, moves to the back, and it is connected. The neck moves around, but also the head has some articulation. But due to all his fur, it's kind of blocked in the head itself, also with the mouth. But you can move that around, and also with the neck. Just combine these two, and it does get some good posability side to side. All the way around, no issue there. Got the big hinge in the shoulder. Shoulder pad doesn't really get into the way. Also can rotate, it is fairly stiff, so I'm not gonna force it that much more. Elbow joints are heavy to move, but they are double hinged. They go up all the way. They are super nicely molded. It looks very seamless. For the hand, you got a big hinge, goes up, down, all the way around. Chest area has some nice back and forward motion. Look at these abs. Side to side, goes all the way around. Watch out for the chains. They are nowhere connected in the lower part, so you should not break anything off that. Just be aware that. Be careful that you don't get stuck anywhere there. Legs move forward, move to the back, does move out to the side and rotates on here. It is on a ball hidden in there, but you don't really have much room. Double hinged knee, which actually not double hinged knee, it's a single big hinge, excuse me, but goes up nicely enough, has some rotation in there. And for the foot, got a big hinge, goes back, forward, and side to side, tilts beautifully. Obviously in an angle, it will adjust to the mold. Now for Toka, it is much of the same, but obviously the neck has some more room because there's no hair blocking it, so you can bring that up and down, can rotate it side to side, head itself. So you combine these two, goes forward very nicely, goes up all the way, does tilt side to side, especially on the head, and rotates without any trouble. Also on the neck itself, hinge same, goes up all the way, but it is somewhat blocked due to the spikes. None of them have a bicep swivel, I just noticed. The elbow does swivel around though on these two spots, making up for the lack of a bicep swivel. Double hinged elbow is again pretty stiff and a little bit blocked due to the elbow pad, but it does still go up like that nicely. And for your hand, same thing, hinge back and forth, rotation. Chest area has nothing going on. Well, actually you have the top part over here which does tilt side to side, a little bit back and forth, but it does not really accomplish anything. It's more of a swivel, just get some tilting side to side. It's all right, I guess they tried. For the leg, it goes forward, It goes out to the side and it doesn't really go to the back, obviously, because of the shell. Rotation on here is a little bit better than with Raza, and we actually have double hinged knees for Toka. Goes all the way up very nicely, and for the feet it is the same thing. You have a hinge, which is pretty blocked because of the big feet. Be careful with that. I kind of have the plastic is ripping off a little bit, so be aware of that. That's unfortunately an issue. Does tilt side to side nicely, but the back and forward motion is tricky. This is all the way back, and let me get it all the way forward again just to show you. Whew, and there you go, stiff. For your accessories, starting off with the hands, again, like open hands, holding hand, well, more holding hands, almost a closed fist, but not completely. And then these claw hands, this one is a little bit more closed actually. Then you got for Toka, you got these holding hands, also a bit clawy, and this almost fist hand. Well, it is somewhat of a fist hand, but it's still also a little bit opened. Then you got a box for your donuts, simply donuts, simple little box. And then you have the donuts with one missing. But where is the one missing? The one thing I kind of like, wish they would have given us is one simple donut that's not cracked open. This is the donut where Raza finds the demutation kind of ice cubes they put in there as bait. Then you got the hubcap to complete the hubcap look for Raza. Kind of just wraps around his arm, I guess. This is just kind of weird connection. Got a fire extinguisher, which the turtles use to spray it in their mouth to speed up the demutation process because it was hindered by them burping all the time. Then he got a steel pipe, which I think is a steel pipe that Raza uses to hit it on, no, Toka hits that on Raza's head while they're sitting in the junkyard, just burping. Somebody hits somebody, I'm not sure anymore. And he got a piece of wood, which again reminds me of the moment where they are unleashed in the city and just destroy everything. Take some light posts apart, and I guess that's where the wood is from. Not completely sure. I remember Toka biting off some wood out of it. That's not really what this is. Oh, and also there's an ooze canister, which just kind of rolled off to the side, trying to get out of the way. Tricky. Has some nice metallic on the sides, TGRI logo, and some green, because there's mutagen in it. And that's gonna bring me to the final thoughts for this Toka and Raza 2-pack. Well, did you hear me say a bad word during this review? No, that's because I didn't have anything bad to say about it. Well, I guess it's NECA joint, so be careful with that. Heat it up. It takes a little bit of working before you even can get them into place. But once you do it, it's fine. The joints also painted, so that flakes off. The joints are going to lose the color over time if we play around with it too much. That's all I can grasp for. And I'm really grasping for bad things, because there really isn't anything bad about these. These guys are amazing. They have an awesome size. Really flawless paint job on mine. I didn't have any problems with like paint bleeding or like spots. Well, there's a little bit of white spots on Toka's shoulder, but that's about it. The paint job itself is just very masterfully applicated. It looks so nice on the fur and then the rust and the dots and whatnot. All the different shades of green on Toka and the shell with the orange and the darker orange and the black, and just the articulation is also very nice, and the accessories are everything you need to have. And yeah, that's it. Recommended 100%, although this was a pre-order exclusive at the NECA store. So if you can still track it down, I know there are a lot of scalpers on eBay and whatnot. I can't really tell you how much this you should pay for this. You should make that up yourself. But for the original price, you were getting it on the NECA store. It was absolutely freaking worth it. And you know, just keep your eyes open, guys. If maybe NECA does another run with these, maybe at some point, maybe not. Yeah, I do recommend these guys. That's gonna do it. As usual, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget, if you enjoyed this review, hit it up with a like and subscribe to the channel so you can stay tuned for more figure reviews, card game stuff, and whatever Toka and Raza wants. Nothing. Absolutely nothing.